Thanks for joining this video on getting started with the new anomaly detection feature from AWS IoT SiteWise. I'm Raju Gottumukkala, a senior IoT solutions architect from AWS. To those new to AWS IoT SiteWise, SiteWise is a fully managed AWS service that is designed to collect, model, store, and visualize data from industrial equipment. It enables manufacturers to monitor their equipment in near real time, improving operational efficiency and to detect failures before they occur, reducing costly equipment breakdowns. In this video, we'll focus on the recently launched native anomaly detection feature part of AWS IoT SiteWise. Traditionally, our customers have been building anomaly detection solutions using AWS IoT SiteWise as the industrial data backbone and one of our AI/ML services, such as Amazon Lookout for Equipment or Amazon SageMaker. This approach often requires months of development effort and also specialized machine learning expertise. For organizations lacking these skills and wanting to realize business value faster, this approach may not be a good fit. The native anomaly detection feature solves this problem by offering a fully managed plug-and-play solution for data collection, data pre-processing, training, and inference workflows. This approach enables rapid development at scale within days without requiring deep ML expertise. Now, let's go through a demo and understand how easy it is to enable anomaly detection on your assets. Here is a quick architecture from the demo. We use e-bike assembly line as a sample scenario in this demo. On the edge component of AWS IoT SiteWise connects to these welding robots and collects telemetry through OPC UA. The collected data is then buffered locally and securely published to the AWS IoT SiteWise service on the cloud. Now, these assets are modeled in SiteWise using its asset modeling capabilities. Next, once anomaly detection is enabled for an asset, SiteWise provides all the required training data to train an anomaly detection model. Any past maintenance records can be provided as data labels to improve the model performance. Once the model is trained and inference is enabled, SiteWise provides live telemetry to the model for decisioning. The inference result is then displayed on an operator dashboard built on Amazon managed Grafana. Operators and plant floor personnel can monitor assets and take corrective actions when there is an anomaly. Let us now switch to a live demo. As a first step, the bike assembly line, along with its asset hierarchy, is modeled in SiteWise. Next, the live telemetry data is collected from edge to cloud. Let's take an example of welding robot. In the welding robot, live measurements such as current, position, temperature are collected from all its joints. Now this asset is ready to be monitored by an operator using an operator dashboard. Next, to enable anomaly detection for this welding robot, we have to follow three simple steps. First, you need to create a template for the anomaly detection model so that you can reuse it for thousands of similar assets. In SiteWise, this template is called a computation model. To create a computation model, we'll go to Computation Models, Anomaly Detection, and then choose Create. We'll give it a name and choose the asset model. So we'll choose the welding robot asset model. Next, you need to choose the properties to be included in the detection model. So here I'm gonna pick the top 5 properties, but you can include more. Finally, you need to pick the output property where SiteWise writes back the anomaly result. And you can review and create the computation model. Now the template is created and we are ready to train an anomaly detection model. To train the model, you have to choose your template first. Since we are already in our newly created template, we are good to go. Select Start Training and pick your asset. So in this case, we'll use the welding robot and choose your training data range. In this case, I'll pick 1 year and use any labels from your maintenance records to further improve the model training performance. Next, you could also choose evaluation data range to assess the training performance. This really helps you decide if the model is good enough for you to promote it to production environment, for example. And finally, start training. This could take few minutes to hours, depending on factors such as the volume of data, the number of variables involved, and so on. Once the training is completed, the next step is to schedule inference. To schedule inference, choose the asset and select schedule. First, you'll pick the data upload frequency. So this is the frequency at which the inference runs. So here we are going to leave it at 5 minutes. And then you can choose some optional settings, especially the offset delay time. This is to accommodate the late arriving data. So I'll keep it 3 minutes. And finally, you can use flexible scheduling to optimize inference costs. Let's say you have assets that are not critical or assets that do not run 24/7. You can choose specific days and times to run inference and save on inferencing cost. Now with this configuration, every 5 minutes, SiteWise runs inference for this model and provides anomaly results that can be presented on a dashboard or used to trigger a notification. With this, we are done with scheduling the inference. Now that we are done with all the 3 steps involved in creating an anomaly detection model, which is creating the template, also known as computation model, training the detection model, and scheduling inference. Next, let us see how you can present the anomaly results in a dashboard. Here is an operator dashboard built on Amazon Managed Grafana. The dashboard helps operators to monitor live telemetry such as the current and temperature across all the joints in the robot. The dashboard also presents the anomaly results every 5 minutes in this case, which are retrieved from SiteWise. The results include anomaly score, which is 0 to 1, and it represents the confidence level and a decision whether there is an anomaly or not. Now this decision uses 0.5 anomaly score as a threshold, but you can define your own threshold depending on the criticality of the machine. SiteWise also provides model explainability, which is displayed in this pie chart. The pie chart shows the top contributing parameters or sensors to each decision. In this case, you can see the top 2 contributing sensors are the temperature and the current from joint 0. This really helps the operators and engineers to quickly diagnose and resolve issues. And that's the end of the demo. Just note that we used AWS Management Console to create this whole workflow. But you can also use AWS SDKs to build the same workflow programmatically. We hope the demo helped you understand how you can leverage the new SiteWise anomaly detection and rapidly deploy anomaly detection models for your assets. Thank you for your time, and please reach out if you have any questions.